that can avoid the total closure of the airport. I so move.
Before I proceed, let me use this very opportunity to say congratulations to my friend and colleague, Senator Hardy, on his appointment as Minister for Aviation. I've tried to reach him a couple of times and I could not. So I use this opportunity to say congratulations to him. Your Excellency, distinguished colleagues, no doubt we have a whole lot of challenges in the aviation sector, including delayed flights, security issues, and even if the structures and infrastructures that needs to be put in place. But I would like to concern myself. I'm going to limit myself to the issue of the closure of the only runway in the international airport at Abuja. Distinguished colleagues, the Honorable Minister for Aviation, my friend Senator Hardy, has told us that there is absolute need to repair the runway at Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport. I agree with him. But what I don't agree with him, sir, is that we will close the airport while the repairs take place. I don't agree with him. I don't agree with him for several reasons. One is that it is not going to be rocket science to repair an existing runway. We've had instances in different countries, different airports, where runways were repaired without closure, including Ghana in West Africa, including Ireland in Europe, Florida, United States of America, many places. So that means that for us to insist that we have to close the runway, close the airport in order to make the repairs, that means we are not thinking deeply. And even to think that this is an airport named after a man like Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, a great thinker himself, that such an airport will be closed without thinking of an alternative means of dealing with it is an insult to the great Sikh. Associating his name to such an airport will be a disservice to him. I'm sure he will turn his grave to know that there's a minister who suggests that the airport should be closed to effect repairs just because we could not think. I've spoken to a number of people in the sector, including PW, CETRACO, and Julius Beja. And my take, and what I got from them, is that there was no proper consultation with those who should know. Otherwise, that airport can function while the repairs goes on. And if you look at the security implications, sir, I'm aware, sir, that the former Minister for Environment and her husband were kidnapped on the Abuja-Kaduna Highway. The former Kaduna chairman of PDP was kidnapped on that same road. My friend, Alhaji, the former liaison officer to the National Assembly, from Borno State, Kashim, he has a farm on that road. He planted maize and millet. He abandoned everything because of security implications. And the same story is a similar story in respect of those who have farm in that corridor. So if people cannot even go to their farm, I can't imagine where people, how people can take risk of going to leave Abuja by 4 a.m. to meet a flight by 8 o'clock, British Airways flight, or leave by 9 o'clock to meet a Lufthansa flight by 11 o'clock in Kaduna. So that means that it's going to be a major nightmare. Even the road itself cannot be recommended for this kind of exercise. That was where we lost our Honorable Minister from Kogi State. So I think this president will do this great country and impair what a great service if we invite Honorable Minister and dialogue with him, together with other stakeholders, and come up with a solution to this problem. Because I believe that dialoguing with the Minister and other stakeholders will be able to bring out other alternatives for which we can follow. And I want to say that this Senate will be acting in the best interest of the country, and that no ego should be involved. If we have a solution, anybody has a solution, the Honourable Minister should be honourable enough to accept that option should be exercised. So I second this motion.